Friends and family, and welcome to this day of celebration. We are united to witness the marriage of Brian and Amy on this special day. We have been invited to share in the commitment they make to each other today. They ask our blessing on this joyful occasion. If life has any meaning to us all, it possesses it because of love. Love enriches our human experience. It is the reason for the peace in the family, and the peace of the peoples of the earth. A meeting between two beings who are deeply connected to each other is a beautiful miracle. Each coming together of a couple has meaning. And I'd like to call upon Sarah to share a blessing for Brian and Amy's union today. Sarah?
Blessing for your marriage. May your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitement marriage should bring. And may life grant you all the patience, also patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you always need one another, not so much to fill the emptiness, but to help you know your fullness.
I'm going to party.
A mountain needs a valley to be complete. The valley does not make the mountain less, but more. And the valley is more a valley because it is a mountain, there is a mountain towering over it. May you need one another, but not out of weakness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you entice one another, but not to compel one another. May you embrace one another, but not out encircle one another. May you succeed in all the important ways with one another and not fail in the little graces. May you look for things to praise, often say, I love you, and take no notice of small faults. If you have quarrels that push you apart, may both of you hope to have good sense enough to take the first step back. May you enter into the mystery, which is the awareness of one another's presence, no more physical, the spiritual, warm and near when you are side by side, and warm and near when you are in separate rooms or even distant cities. May you have happiness, and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love, and may you find it one another.
Before the meeting of any two couples, each often travels their own journey. And a journey is composed of many stories. And I'd first like to call upon Amy's father, Floyd, to come and share one of these stories.
On Amy's journey leading to today's wedding ceremony, what visible impact has resulted from her relationship with Brian? Simply stated, the answer is the glow of happiness. Happiness that is a special relationship, a relationship that has stemmed from two friends becoming soulmates and then growing into the intensity of young love. Happiness that is having a partner who embraces being a part of her life and having her as a part of his. Partners must share fully in each other's lives to have true happiness. Happiness that is the joining of two circles of friends. Friends, old and new, are an important part of continuing happiness on our journey through life. Happiness that is the joining of two families. Amy and Brian have joined each other's families. Family is an important part of both their lives, and happiness can only come with a true joining of their families. Happiness that is the creation of a new family. The bond created when two people choose each other to be the parents of their children brings a new level of happiness. Told you. Stay soulmates, grow your love, share your lives, your friends and families. Love you, children, and keep the globe of happiness.
And continuing on the journey of stories, I'd like to call on Brian's father, Bob, to also come and share one of these stories.
Brian's journey with Amy. The journey through life, upon which each and every one of us embarks, includes many discoveries along the way. There are crossroads which require a choice of direction, and meetings with fellow travelers, some of which invite just more than a passing glance. Today we witness the joining of two of life's journeys, one that Amy and Brian will now continue together. I see a wonderful adventure in store for them both. Pride and self-esteem are very evident in Brian since he met Amy, and with that sense of purpose, taking on tasks of home renovation, helping to build this handsome deck behind you. I also sense contentment. He's pleased with himself and his future with Amy. He is confident and self-assured, taking on a career change, moving to a new home, all the time preparing for this wonderful day. Since Brian met Amy, his step is lighter, his smile even brighter. He is more forward-thinking, broadening his circle of friends while maintaining loyalty to those he has known for years. Brian has come to treasure Amy and to appreciate the promise of their future. I see great optimism for our son, full of hope for their tomorrow.
Brian and Amy's understanding of the true meaning of marriage can be and has been a result from many influences, their families, their friends, and each of their own personal experiences. We here not only strengthen the binds of Amy and Brian's love for each other, but also to bring family and friends together to celebrate these same bonds that connect us all together. What defines Brian and Amy's love today will change and grow to new depths in the future. It takes 3 seconds to say I love you, but it can take a lifetime to show it. This ceremony is a celebration of a single stage in a much larger process. That is the love between a husband and a wife. The promises made today and the ties that are bound here greatly strengthen your union. They will cross the years and the lives of each other's souls grow. Do you, Brian and Amy, seek to begin the ceremony?
We do.
We do.
Brian, repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Brian Shawcross.
Why I, Brian Shawcross.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony to Amy Campbell.
In matrimony to Amy Campbell.
Amy, repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Any lawful impediment.
Any lawful impediment.
Why I, Amy Campbell.
Why I, Amy Campbell.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony to Brian Chakra.
In matrimony to Brian Chakra.
Now turn to each other. Brian, repeat after me. I call upon these people here.
I call upon these people here.
Present to witness that.
Present to witness that.
I, Brian Chakra.
I, Brian Chakra.
Do take thee.
Do take thee.
Amy Campbell.
Amy Campbell.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
Amy, repeat after me. I call upon these people here.
I call upon these people here.
Presence to witness that.
Presence to witness that.
I, Amy Campbell.
I, Amy Campbell.
Do take thee. Do take thee.
Brian Chakra.
Brian Chakra. To be my lawfully.
To be my lawfully.
Wedded husband. Now offer each other your hands. The hand which each offer to the other is an extension of yourself. Just as the warmth and love which you express to each other, cherish the touch, for you are touching another life. Be sensitive to its pulse, and try to understand and respect its flow and rhythm
just as you do your own. Brian, I understand you have some vows you'd like to say to me.
Today, as I give myself to you, my mind is clear and my commitment is strong. I take you to be my life's partner. I am honored to spend the rest of my life at your side. You have made me complete. Whatever happens in the future, I promise to always love and support you. I've been waiting all my life to find you, and now that I have, I'll never let you go. You're a wonderful, caring, and understanding person. You truly are one of a kind. In front of our friends and family here with us today, I want to say that I'm so proud to become your husband. I love you.
Amy.
Oh dear.
It just wouldn't be the same if it didn't. Brian, you already are the love of my life, my partner and my best friend. Your strength bring me strength when I am feeling defeated. Your kindness and respect towards others teaches me every day of how to be a person I strive to be. Only you can turn my mood around without even trying to do so stupid. That leads me to tears for about survival. Your humble spirit gives me perspective while humbling you in return. And your genuinity, although not actually a word, should have a picture of you beside it in the dictionary. There is no one more honest or genuine than you. Knowing this has always brought me complete trust and confidence in our relationship. Our life and our future together. So as I now stand before you to say I, Amy, take you, Brian, to be my husband, I vow to you to take these qualities I cherish most in you and greet you always with the same, so that you can experience the best of life as you brought to me. Brian, I vow to you that I will not only be there for you during good times and bad, through whatever obstacles may come, and to be your constant friend and faithful partner. I promise to love you more with each passing day and take the time each day to remember why I chose to stand here today with you and only you, and to remember just how lucky I am that Brian Shawcross's heart belongs to me.
And so the binding is made. May I have the ring? A circle is the symbol of the sun, and the earth, and the universe, of wholeness, and peace, and love. These rings mark the beginning of a long journey together. Wear them proudly, for they are the symbols which speak of the love that you have for each other. Brian, please take the ring and place it on Amy's finger, and repeat after me. This ring, is a sign of our love.
Sign of our love.
And my commitment to you.
And my commitment to you.
Amy, take the ring. Place it on Brian's finger. And repeat after me. This ring. Is a sign of our love.
Is a sign of our love.
And my commitment to you.
And my commitment to you.
Having given the rings, I tie these bonds. And I now present you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. And I'd like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Shawcross.
No.